In this video, I'm going to be talking about how you can do things like this. Yeah, they just got pooped on. Before the video does start, I'd like to quickly give a huge thank you to SteelSeries for sending me out one of their Arctis 7P Plus wireless headsets. Later on in the video, I will be talking about why it is very important to have a good headset, and this is the headset that I would really recommend at the moment. There are so many good features about this headset, and if you want to get your hands on one of these headsets, there will be a link in the description. Let's get straight into tip number one on how to get better at Rebirth Island. Tip number one is going to be minimap awareness. The minimap is going to give away so many different things. As you can see right now, there are two dots with arrows beneath them, which tells me there are teams shooting below me. As you can see, I go ahead and wipe these teams out very, very easily because I know exactly where they are. Also, whenever you kill an enemy in Rebirth, their teammates are actually going to appear on the minimap and you're going to see exactly where they are. And as you can see, I know exactly where this guy is because he appeared on the minimap, so I can go ahead and wipe them out. So now I want to talk about why it's really important to have a good headset. Like I mentioned, SteelSeries sent me out one of their headsets, and ever since I've been using that headset, I have definitely seen some massive improvements in my gameplay. One of the biggest things about having a headset is the fact that you're going to be able to hear enemies' footsteps incredibly easy. For example, here I pick up my loadout and there is an enemy in this window. I down him and I instantly go ahead and push to try and finish that enemy off. However, as I approach, I hear footsteps, and this allows me to be more prepared for this guy who comes sliding around the corner. If I didn't have the headset on and I didn't hear those footsteps, I would have 100% died right there. The SteelSeries Arctis 7Ps are definitely a headset you should consider buying. It has a retractable mic, the sound quality is amazing. My favorite thing about the headset is the fact that it is just really comfy as well. This band is so much more comfy than the hard headset that I used to wear. And it's wireless, so you don't even have a wire that's gonna get in the way whenever you're gaming. It also has a fast charge feature. You charge it for 15 minutes and it gives you 3 hours of usage, which is amazing. The next tip I wanna talk about is positioning and movement, two of the most important things. So to do this, I'm gonna grab the first clip you saw in the intro and break it down on exactly what I was doing. First of all, I use the stim to increase my movement speed. The faster I am, the harder it is for them to hit the target. As soon as I enter this building, I get lit up from behind, so I quickly chuck a slide in there to throw his aim off, and luckily it worked and I ended up downing this enemy. His teammate comes running around and I instantly snap onto him and down him. Now, there's one more guy left. I have no cover apart from a tiny bit to my right, so I have to use that, otherwise I'm dead. I slide towards it, use it, and then quickly jump up so he doesn't expect it, and that team is wiped. Equally as important to do things like this are your settings. So let's go ahead and hop straight into my settings. For sensitivity, that is all personal preference, so just use whatever sensitivity you are comfortable with. The best tip I have for this is to play a game with a sensitivity, see how it feels, and just keep changing it until you find one you like. One of the most important settings is this one right here. Use and reload behavior. Make sure to turn this on contextual tap. This will make it so you don't need to hold the button down to pick things off the floor. You can just tap the button and it will instantly pick it up, and it allows you to be a lot quicker. Armor plate behavior, make sure this is on apply all. Slide behavior must be on tap. This makes it so you can just press the slide button and you'll instantly slide, and this just makes movement tons quicker and it lets you slide cancel. Automatic sprint should be on automatic tactical sprint. And then over to graphics, camera movement should be on the least amount possible. World motion blur and weapon motion blur should be disabled. Film grain on 0, brightness around 55, and on-demand texture streaming should be disabled, otherwise your game will have a little bit more lag. For interface, the only one you need to change is minimap shape to square, because then the minimap will be bigger. The next tip I want to talk about is landing in the same spot every single game. This is the most important tip I have for you guys, and this is gonna honestly help you win so many more games. It makes a massive difference. The start of the match can literally change what the whole entire match is going to be like. I land at Grandma's house every single game. I know where every single bit of loot is. I know where every single crate is going to spawn, and I know where all of the enemies are also going to be. And this is really important so I can get as much loot as possible and I can obviously get the guns I need, get my loadout as fast as possible, get a bunch of cash. And it's just a massive help to land in the same spot. Land somewhere you're used to. If you land somewhere you're not used to, you're not going to know where any of the loot is and you're just not going to have a very good start to the game. I have a lot more tips to share with you guys, so make sure to go ahead and comment down below or leave a like on this video if you guys want a part 2. If you made it all the way to the end of the video, comment down chicken nuggets down below so I know who the real OGs are. Leave a like, drop a sub, and make sure to check out Steel Series. The link is in the description. Peace out.